A legend of horror lurks in the haze. It's Bigfoot, giant of a creature, all covered with hair. As tall as a timber and strong as a bear. Y'all better not go walking out there with
you know,
Bigfoot.
Blubber, when we catch this Yeti, I'm set for life.
Bigfoot's coming, gonna get you. Bigfoot's coming, so you better watch out. Lock your doors and bolt your windows. Bigfoot's on the prowl. Bigfoot's on the prowl. For hundreds of years, this legend has grown. At the top of the world, it's the Yeti that's known as a mountain monster 10 feet tall, called Bigfoot. From the tales of the traders and trappers, to the image on Indian walls, from the frozen slopes of the Himalayas, to the signs of the great Shastas. From the Flatheads to Blackfeet and the Sherpas, he must have seen them all. When the sun goes down, the wind blows cold. If you listen, you can hear him call.
But I thought they were supposed to be bigger than that. Like a Bigfoot, but mean it.
That's why nobody's ever found one before, because they've been looking for the wrong animal.
So we're the first people in history to ever see a real Yeti?
No. I'm the first person in history to catch a Yeti.
You know what to do?
Yes, Mr. Grizzly.
You make one mistake and I'll have your guts for dinner, son.
Tent. Hey, hey, you looking for something?
Hi. Is this your tent?
Yeah. You guys American?
Big Jake Grizzly. World's greatest hunter. You may have heard of me. This is my assistant, Blubber. You won't have heard of him.
What were you doing in a tent?
Nothing. I'm looking for an animal. Small, furry little creature.
A Yeti.
A what?
Just... it's my assistant's little joke.
Shut up.
You guys climbers?
Yeah.
You been here long?
Heading back today. Where are you guys from?
Texas, and you?
Upstate New York.
Uxbridge.
Well, it's a pleasure meeting you gentlemen. It's time we be off. We're just gonna finish our afternoon stroll. All right.
later.
Bye, y'all. Come on, Blubber.
Don't you ever mention the word Yeti to anyone again, Blubber. You understand me?
Yes, Mr. Grizzly.
He's mine. We've been tracking him for weeks, and I'm not gonna let you screw up now.
You really sure he's a Yeti, Mr. Grizzly?
Do you doubt me, Blubber?
No, no, I guess I expected some big hairy monster after following those gigantic footprints all this way. Why is such a tiny creature like that got such big feet?
So he doesn't sink in the snow when he's walking. That's why, Blubber. Give me the binoculars. Can you give them to me the right way, please?
What the hell?
Give me the real ones next time.
We gonna make it?
Close. You got everything in?
No. You got room in your pack for the stove and fuel?
Your pack full?
Yeah, I don't understand it. I mean, I got everything in it on the way up.
Where do you think he went?
Well, he didn't disappear into thin air when he comes out of hiding. I'll get him.
I'm freezing, Mr. Grizzly, and hungry.
Shut up, Blubber. Just shut up.
Well, how long are we gonna wait here?
Get down, Blubber, get down.
What happened?
Shh, follow me.
What are you looking for, Mr. Grizzly?
Footprint. Look here. Yeti skis down the mountain. Stops here.
That's where the tent was. Footprints leading into the tent. None leading out.
I don't get it. Where is he now, then?
There's only one place he could be. Damn!
We'll never get him now, Mr. Grizzly.
I'm not so sure about that.
Those climbers will be in the States long before we catch up with them.
Yeah. So? We'll let them take him home, then I'll snatch him back.
So, Dad, did you do it?
Well, let me just get my backpack off first.
Did you do it?
Well, I don't know if I want to tell you guys right now.
Come on, Dad, please tell me.
It's okay, honey. He's dying to tell us.
Well, I don't want to brag, but you guys are looking at one of only two people in the world that has climbed the southwest face of Mount Pinjananga.
Yes.
All 12,482 feet.
Was it fun? Was it dangerous? Did you see any abominable snowmen?
Well, I saw a couple of abominable snowmen, but they took one look at Mike's face and went running down the mountain screaming.
Are you hungry?
And dirty, and tired, and jet-lagged.
I made you a pumpkin pie. Do you want a slice?
Tell you what, you go cut me a big piece and I'll have it after my shower.
Sure, I'll get it.
What did you say? Yes, sir. Anything you want. I made a big mistake.
Yeah, that's what I thought you said. Come on now.
Help Blubber. Get up. The man's gonna help you with the bag. Open the door.
Bigger, bigger, bigger.
The pie's outside the door.
Okay, thanks, honey. You'll be down in a minute.
Okay.
Fly me to...
Those for me, we'll chop those too.
Very funny.
What do you mean?
I mean, very funny. Where's my pie?
I brought enough for you. I told you I would.
Honey, what you brought me was an empty plate and a fork.
I didn't.
He's kidding you, Amy.
You're kidding us, Dad.
Any excuse for some more? I'll get you some.
I came all the way home to see you. I should give you an empty plate. Thank you.
Do you like it?
Mm-hmm.
I think that was a yes.
Mm, very good.
Better than Mum's?
Better than Mum's.
I told you you'd like it.
I have something for you, too, you know.
You mean a present?
Maybe.
Where is it, upstairs?
Well, why don't you go upstairs and check?
It's a teddy bear.
Amy?
Mom, Dad!
What is it? What happened?
My present. It escaped.
What do you mean?
The animal. It ran into your backpack.
Wait a second. What are you talking about? What animal?
My present. The one you brought me.
No. This is the present I brought you from Nepal.
No, it scared me. It was like a teddy bear. It went behind the chair.
It's okay, honey. It's all right. It didn't hurt you, did it?
No, it ran out of your backpack. Now we know who ate your pie.
What are we gonna do? I mean, we can't just leave it there behind the chair.
I don't know. I mean, I've never seen anything like this.
Is it?
What do I look like?
What? Isn't there someone we can call
okay,
or something?
We can't call somebody. It's against the law. I could go to jail, okay? I just...
Hey! You took it.
How are we gonna find those two climbers, Mr. Grizzly?
Just leave everything up to me, Blubber. Big Jake Grizzly always finds what he's looking for. You ought to know that by now.
Right, Mr. Grizzly?
How about this? Oh, wow. I still don't like it, though. Can't we catch it with a net or something?
No, Mom. I know what I'm doing.
Wait a second, honey. Why don't you let one of us go first?
No, Dad. You guys are too big. You might scare them. Let me try first.
Just be careful.
Took it. He looks so hungry.
Well, he must be after being in my backpack for 3 days.
I'll try Frankfurter. Guess he doesn't like Frankfurters.
Maybe it's a vegetarian. Try an apple.
He's holding my hand. He might come out. He's smiling at me.
Big Jake Grizzly to see Mr. Sturgeon. He's expecting me.
Can I offer you a drink?
No thanks, Mr. Sturgeon. You got my telegram?
Yes, I did, but I'm not sure I understood it properly.
You say you actually found a Yeti?
That's right.
So they do exist. Thank goodness for that.
I knew I could rely on you, Grizzly.
Are you sure it's a real Yeti? Wesley won't settle for anything less.
Yes, ma'am. It's the real thing, all right, and I'll have it here in less than 48 hours. I need to borrow a car first.
Well, you can use one of the limos anytime you want.
See ya.
Hello, darling. Who's this?
Wesley, this is Mr. Grizzly, the man I hired to find you a Yeti.
So where is it?
Now, son. Everything is under control. Mr. Grizzly is one of the best hunters in the world.
The best.
So where is it? Give me it.
It's not here at this moment.
You'll have it soon, son.
I better. I don't. I'm gonna make your lives hell.
You seem to be doing a pretty good job of that already.
Have you found it yet?
Not yet.
It's a he, Mom.
How do you know?
I looked. Can we keep him?
Well, you can't just bring animals into the country, honey. You know, there are regulations and quarantine, that kind of thing.
That smells good.
Well, she'll be ready in a couple of minutes.
Well, nothing in this book.
What I can't understand is how it got into your backpack. I mean, didn't you look in it before you left?
No, it was in the tent the whole time, and I...
What?
Well, I was just thinking, when we came down the mountain, there were two guys, American guys, they were going through our tent, and they said that they were hunting this small creature.
Did they say what it was they were hunting?
No. Well, yeah, but no, that wouldn't be right.
What can't be right?
Well, the guy must have been joking.
Joking?
He said he was hunting a Yeti.
Are you serious?
A Yeti?
Well, that's what he said.
I mean, isn't that just a myth? I mean, no one's ever seen a Yeti.
That I know of.
Well, so if they do exist, who's to say what they look like?
Well, I guess people just assume that they're big and ferocious, but...
But they must be large. Don't they leave giant footprints in the snow?
Yeah, you don't think...
Did you find this place, Uxbridge, yet, Mr. Grizzly?
Yeah, I got it. Some hick town in the middle of nowhere with two houses and a dog.
And a Yeti.
Yeah, my Yeti.
What's the matter with him? Why isn't he eating?
He's probably not hungry after all the food you fed him earlier.
No, look at his face.
I don't know, honey. He doesn't look well.
He's sick.
God, he's boiling hot. It's too hot for him in here. He's used to the mountains. Come on, we need to cool him down. Why don't you put him in the sink and I'll get some ice?
Yeah, okay.
I'll get the ice cream. He's not gonna die, is he?
We don't know if he can survive in this environment.
Please, don't die.
He's not gonna die, honey.
Please, don't die. It's really good for you. Please, eat it. It's really good for you. Please. Please eat it.
I think he's cooling down already.
Please. 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 Please eat it.
Hey.
There you go.
Well, I guess that's all we have to do is keep his temperature down.
Yeah, and feed him lots of ice cream.
Well, I think the best thing for him to do is sleep outside tonight. Well, I mean, it's cooler out there.
No, Dad. I have a better idea.
I think he's going to be all right, Amy.
Well, listen, it's been a long day for all three of us. What do you say we get some sleep? Huh?
Okay. Good night, Yeti.
I don't believe it. Amy, wake up! Why are you sleeping on the floor?
Oh. Hi, Mom. Lydia was lonely, so I decided to be with him.
This is a mess, you know that.
Didn't you hear him?
Well, he probably wanted a snack.
A snack, honey? He's eaten half the house.
He's been everywhere.
He didn't know. He probably didn't even mean it. Can we still keep him?
Don't get too attached to him, Amy. He might have to go to a zoo or someplace scientists can study him.
A zoo? They're gonna put him in a cage.
Listen, don't worry about that right now, okay? Just get him upstairs, get him cleaned.
That'll teach you to mess up the kitchen. How'd you get so much food on your face? Don't do that. Stop. Behave yourself. Oh. Put the toothpaste down. I'm gonna have to clean up the whole bathroom. This is my room. Okay. Sit here and don't move. Let me take it off you. It's too hot. Let me show you my toys. This is Noel the troll, Dave the dog, Jereen, Danielle, Bobo the bear, Greener the gorilla, and Lionel the rat, and Muck the mud monster. You okay? You're not hurt, are you? Don't worry, it's not a real mud monster. It's fake. How about you? You need a name too, don't you? I used to have a toy dog with big floppy ears and big brown eyes like yours. His name was Hank. I'm gonna call you Hank too. How's that sound? I'm Amy and you're Hank. Do you understand? Okay. Let's get dressed, Hank. Hank? Boy, are you gonna be trouble?
How does this help us, Mr. Grizzly?
It helps this way. These two guys were climbing in Nepal, right? It's a small town, and there's bound to be a story. We find these guys, and we find that Yeti.
Come on, honey, here you go. Yes.
Oh, would she be all right with them on her own for a couple of minutes, do you think?
You'd be okay, won't you?
Hank's no problem.
Hank?
Hank?
He has to have a name.
Okay. I'll be a minute.
Okay, you lock the door, okay?
Buy lots and lots of ice cream. Bye,
yeah.
Dad.
Bye. Bye.
Hank?
That's them!
I found them. Dave Bristow. Mike Kelly. Officer Mike Kelly.
You mean one of them's a cop?
One of them's a cop. Let's stay away from him. Dave Bristow, age 37, married. Wife's name is Kate. Daughter's name is Amy. Runs a camping goods store.
His daughter runs a camping goods store, Mr. Grizzly?
Are you stupid?
Yes?
I'm gonna go out for a bit. Just take any messages.
No problem.
Here, have some of this. And I'll probably cool you down. That's our cabin in the Adirondacks. We go out there to ski. What's the matter, Hank? Is it the mountains? Is it the snow? You want to go outside? You can't. Someone's gonna see you. Here, have some of this.
Let's buy some camping equipment.
Wait here.
Nice store. Mr. Bristow around?
Oh, you just missed him. He's gone out. Can I help you?
Well, maybe. I met Dave in Nepal. And he was climbing. And he told me that anytime I was in town, just to come on into the store. So I did, hoping to find him.
He'll be back pretty soon if you want to wait.
I'll wait.
My pleasure.
No. My pleasure. Just remembered something. I should probably go on up to the house and see his wife, Kate.
That's a good idea.
Yeah.
The address slips my mind, though.
Oh, no problem. It's Summer Haven number 634.
Summer Haven.
Mm-hmm. Go left at the top of Main, then straight out of town, then make a right at the gas station.
You still want to go outside, don't you? Well, we shouldn't really, but maybe for a short while.
Hi there. How are you?
Fine.
Keep still, Hank. I know it's hot, but it's just until we get in the woods. Then I'll take them off you. Do you want the picture? Here, keep the picture. Wait here, Hank.
Hi, little girl. Can I come in?
Who are you?
Oh, you see, I'm from immigration, and I came to get the Yeti.
Come back here, little girl. Little girl, I just want to talk to you. I just want to talk to you about the Yeti. Wait, I just want to talk.
They said they met you in Nepal.
Say that again.
They said they met you in Nepal.
What did these guys look like?
Well, one was very big.
With a fur coat?
Mm-hmm.
Obviously, the hunters.
They gone out to see her wife.
You gave them my address?
Well, yes, shouldn't I?
Thank you, Swell. She's out there all by herself, you know. Something's wrong.
Oh, he wants the Yeti. Come on, little girl. Little girl.
Know it.
Little kids shouldn't play in the rain. Okay? You want to go back inside? Good idea.
Bubba, get down here now.
Get in there, Mr. Grizzly.
It's not still in there. I want you to take the Yeti. It doesn't make any difference. Take the Yeti, put it in the car. Don't let it out of the car. We're going to New York to see the Sturgeons. Let's go.
No, come back here.
Let me go, you big gorilla.
Yeah, big gorilla.
Let's go. We're going downstairs.
Go on.
What's in here? Fine, you stay in there. Play with your dolls or something, little girl.
Come on.
No, hey, come back.
Let's get out of here.
Come back.
Open the door.
No.
I got what I came for.
Plates?
In New York. It was one of those fancy plates.
Personalized.
Dollars.
What was that?
D-O-L-L-A-R-S.
Amy?
Mom!
We're in here, Kay.
I'm going to run a check on those plates.
What's going on?
Thanks, Mike.
Tell me.
Hank's gone.
What?
Two guys forced their way in here and took the Yeti. The two hunters I met from Nepal.
Amy, are you all right?
She's going to be okay. She's a little shaken, but she'll be fine.
How could they know it was here?
He's a Yeti. They even said he was a Yeti. The big man, he was so nasty. They're going to hurt Hank. I know they are.
It's okay.
Yes, that sounds like the same one, exactly, okay? But it's New York plates, black.
What will they do to Hank? They won't kill him, will they?
Listen, we'll work something out somehow, okay?
You said they were hunters.
Hey, what do you got?
Well, it's registered to a Mr. Arnold Sturgeon's, New York City. Here's the address.
You know any more?
It's a limo. Personalized plates. Obviously money.
So it couldn't have been Grizzly's car, then?
No, it's not listed as stolen. Maybe they borrowed it.
Can you put out an alert?
An alert for a stolen Yeti? The guys at headquarters would kill themselves.
But they broke in here, terrorized Amy, and took him by force.
An illegal animal, Kate. Imported illegally. You make a stink about this, and you'll have a lot of awkward questions to answer.
There's got to be something we can do.
There is. We can get him back.
Now, wait a second, honey. Now, Mike's got some good points here, okay? It's not as simple as you think it is.
Well, I'm not sitting here while that big hairy monster hurts Hank. I'm gonna get him back.
Amy, now wait a minute, okay? We can't do this in a hurry.
Why not? We have to get him back. They don't know if Hank gets too high, he can die.
Amy, take it easy. We can't head off to New York just like that.
Why not? That big gorilla's got Hank. He needs our help. If you don't help me, I'll do it on my own.
Amy?
Good lady.
Listen, don't worry about it. Okay, she'll be up there 10 minutes. She'll be fine. She'll be cooled off. She'll be okay.
I don't know, Dave. I've never seen her this upset.
She'll be fine.
Seems the ticket agent at the bus station remembers a little girl matching Amy's description who bought a ticket for New York.
Sorry, this is all my fault. I realized how attached she was becoming to him.
Oh, Dave, Amy's alone in New York.
I know, listen, we'll do something. Please just calm down, all right? Now listen, we know she's after the Sturgis guy, right? So we'll just jump in the car and drive to the city.
The car's broken down. I left it in the supermarket parking lot.
Okay, listen, no big deal. Just take the train. It's quicker anyway.
Look, if I drive you to Albany, we'll get there around the same time as her.
See? Hey. It's perfect.
We've lost in 3 months. 2 electrocutions, a nervous breakdown, a skateboard concussion, and multiple injuries from a piranha in the bath. All of them caused by Wesley. What are we going to do, Arnold?
All right, Angelica. I'll call the agency and ask them to send someone new tomorrow.
About Wesley? The boy's a psychopath.
What is it, Hayes?
Mr. Grizzly and his assistant are here, sir.
Show them in. I hope you've got some good news for us, Grizzly.
I have your Yeti, Mr. Sturgeon.
That's a Yeti?
That's a Yeti.
You hired me to catch a Yeti, Mr. Sturgeon, and I've done just that.
Well, yes, I know, but I didn't expect it to look like this.
So
small, so harmless looking. Wesley wanted a monster with a horrible temper and a thirst for blood. A pet he could identify with.
I've delivered the goods. You deliver the money.
How can we be sure it really is a Yeti?
Because I'm Big Jake Grizzly. And Big Jake Grizzly catches what he's hired to catch. Man-eating monsters that prowl the Himalayas? They don't exist. But a Yeti exists. And that, right there, that's a Yeti. And there'll probably never be another one caught.
Shouldn't it be in a cage or something?
It's not dangerous.
Hey, said you were here. Geez, you're ugly. Who's the lard butt?
My name's Arnie Blubber Schwarzenkopf.
Figures.
Mr. Grizzly has found you a Yeti, Wesley. Isn't he cute?
That's not a Yeti.
It is, dearest. The only one in the world. And he's all yours. Why don't you take him away and play with him?
Is this some kind of scam? It's a monkey with big feet. Not a Yeti.
I'm sure it will get bigger, darling.
I told you this guy was a jerk.
Walk easy, kid. I didn't come here to be insulted.
Where do you usually go?
Listen, you sawed off little runt. You wanted a Yeti, and I got you a Yeti, okay?
Oh, let me.
Hey, you say one more rude word to me, and I promise you this, I'll throw you across the room.
You idiot!
$4.5 million now.
Yes, of course. I just have to call the bank and they'll send a courier right around.
I'll be back in a half hour. Half hour.
Yes.
Mr. Grizzly certainly has a way with children, don't you think, dear?
Boy, are we gonna have some fun with you.
Do you think we made it in time?
I hope so. Mike said her bus would have arrived 10 minutes before our train. Better look around.
Did you hear something?
What?
There it is again.
It's coming from over there. Let's check it out.
Sweetheart, goodness, you're all right. Worried about you.
Why'd you run out like that? You could have come to us and talked to us.
But Dad, you didn't listen. Pain can't survive in this weather. He needs our help.
Just hold on there a second, honey. Okay, now your mother and I are going to turn everything over to the authorities. As for us, there's a train leaving for Albany tonight at 6:30, and we're going to be on it.
That easy. How do we get in there?
I don't know.
You'll think of something, won't you, Dad?
me.
Oh, come on, Dave. There's got to be a way.
Kate, look at this place. You know the kind of lawyers a place like this buys? I can't just walk up to the front door and say we want the Yeti back because our daughter needs it.
Well, couldn't you pretend to be calling on business or something? Anything to get us in that front door.
I'm not that good at that kind of thing. You know that.
Come on, Dave.
Please, Dad?
Hi, doll. U.S. Customs. I'm here to see Mr. Sturgeon.
Do you have any identification?
Don't need any. Just tell him I'm here to see him about the Yeti.
You better come in and see Hayes.
Thanks.
Sturgeon better come up with the money or he's gonna limp for life.
You're great, Dad.
They got in here.
Can you hear something? It's Hank. He's up there.
Thanks.
Well, you, what is all this nonsense about?
United States Customs Service, Manhattan Division. Name's Callahan, Harry Callahan. Now, why don't you step back, sit down, and shut up?
He's in here. They're hurting him.
Not anymore, they're not.
I think either one of you realize who you're dealing with here. I've put away more two-bit scumbags like you two, and I'll
tell you right in a minute. You got a problem?
Because you got a problem, that's fabulous. You got a problem? I make a little phone call. A little phone call, and within 20 minutes, I got the FBI, the CIA, the DEA, CBS, ITT, SOS, and they'll do it, pal, because I've seen them. Now, I got one little simple message for the two of you. Don't mess with me. Because if you mess with me...
Stop that thing! Stop my Yeti!
There's gonna be problems. So I want you two to keep your noses clean. Because we'll be watching both of you. Thank you for our time.
Keep going, Amy!
She is, Blubber.
Dave! Oh, Dave!
Hey, you're no customs officer. Call the police, Hayes. Oh, I got money! Oh, no!
Oh, let's get out of here.
My money! Wesley, don't you keep any?
We seem to be getting away, sir.
You on your own, kid?
Keep going, please.
Where to?
Anywhere, just go! Hurry up!
We're never gonna find her. This is New York!
Listen, don't say that. We haven't checked down there. Come on.
You got any money, kid?
About $3?
$3? Give me it.
How far will that get me?
This far. Out.
No, please help me. Two men are chasing me.
I don't care. Out.
Yes, Chief. She's about 10 years old. Long black hair, pink coat.
They forced their way in here and assaulted my son, and then assaulted me. And then they escaped with my son Wesley's pet. You'll put out an alert? Excellent.
Tell them you're offering a reward.
I'll be giving a reward, Chief. Say $1,000.
Ten!
Wesley,
100!
Make it $10,000. Thanks, Chief. And if you ever need a favor in the future, yes, I'm sure there will be an occasion. Goodbye. Well, now every police officer in this city will be after them. They'll get them.
She's gone, Mr. Grizzly!
I know that. We gotta figure out a way to get across here.
There's nothing to worry about. They're not gonna get you. I promise. Shh.
She's gone, Mr. Grizzly.
Nah, she's around here. I can't smell anything in this city. Look, you go that way, we'll flush her out.
Catching a train at 6:30 at the station. I'm willing to bet she's gonna head there.
So you're saying we should just go there and wait for her?
Hey, what else are we gonna do? We've got no other choice. Okay, come on.
Jiu-jitsu and Aikido. Don't mess with me, man.
Interesting. Flubber.
It's the heat, isn't it? I gotta cool you down. Hank. Oh, I didn't know what I have done if you died. Maybe I should give you to someone. Huh? Look after you.
No, wait! Stop! Help! Help!
We lost her, Mr. Grizzly. She's too smart for us.
Nobody's smarter than Big Jake Grizzly. We made a mistake in chasing this little girl. We're gonna use our brains now. Well, I'm gonna use mine at least. Yours doesn't work.
She's never gonna make it.
We still got 10 minutes left. Look, if she's not here by the time the train leaves, we'll turn ourselves into the police.
She'd have been here by now. They must have caught her.
Come on, I told you earlier. This is the only place she knows in the city. We gotta believe she's gonna show up here.
Now then, I'm gonna ask you this. Which way has that little girl been running ever since we've been chasing her? No, not that way. She's been going south. Now, which way south? South is that way. And what's 3 blocks south of here?
The train station.
Hank, it's so cold in here. I'm frozen.
The back. Hey, pull over, man.
Can you please tell me where the station is? That way? Thank you very much.
Last train to Clarksville.
Am I glad to see you?
Oh, thank goodness you're all right. You look exhausted.
I'm fine. So is Hank. I think I lost the hunters uptown.
No, you didn't.
How'd they get here?
He's right by our train.
We gotta get out of here. Rent a car or something.
No, we can't. It's too risky.
The Greyhound, then.
It's the same thing. I mean, they're looking for us all over town. We've gotta get on that train.
How are we gonna do that with Grizzly right there? We've only got a few minutes left.
Wait a second. Wait a second. Grizzly only knows what Amy and I look like. He only got a glimpse of you. He probably wouldn't recognize you if you walked by him.
So how does that help us?
Could be a way.
The train on platform 7 is now boarding. All stops to Windsor.
Mr. Grizzly, I searched the whole train, Mr. Grizzly. She's not on it.
Would you get a move on? If I miss my train, there'll be no tip for you.
Are you sure?
Yeah. They got away. All three of them with the Yeti.
They're on a train heading north.
Some hunters. So why didn't she catch them?
Do you know where they were heading to?
Albany. It's the station closest to their house. You have any influence with the Albany police?
I own most of them.
Is that right? Well, then you tell them to catch the 615 out of New York. They should hold the kid and the parents till I get there. Also call the Uxbridge police. Tell them to watch the house just in case. 634 Summerhaven. The name is Bristow. Got it? Okay.
Lover? I'm going too.
Are you kidding? I'm not taking a boy on a man's job.
Now listen, Grizzly. Why don't you take the boy? There'll be a bonus in it for you.
How much?
Say 50.
Make it 100.
Done. Grizzly, Mr. Grizzly would like to take you with him. Won't that be exciting, son?
The limousine is outside, sir.
Get my coat, Hayes. I'm going too.
Your pet was wearing this when it arrived. Will you be needing it now?
Catch that Yeti, Grizzly.
You'll have it.
These guys couldn't catch a cold in the North Pole.
Now I put a few things in the limo for you, sir.
Maybe more without Wesley.
Arnold, why don't we go away?
Greece. Do you remember Greece?
On our own home?
I'll make those calls to the police. First, Hayes, pack our bags. We're leaving tonight.
And Hayes, don't tell Wesley where we've gone.
You know, I haven't felt this good since I've seen my IRS at one.
Come on, Ben!
Mike, it's Dave.
Thank goodness you phoned. Where are you?
Well, we got off the train to stop early.
Good thing you did. They're watching the station.
Yeah, I figured as much.
Hurry up! They're gonna get away!
Listen, I want you to do me a favor. I want you to listen closely. I want you to get our Jeep and take it to the Denham station. We're hiding around the corner from it.
Yeah, sure. No problem.
My boss is a friend of the Bristows, and I was wondering if they've been by at all.
Nope.
I suppose you could spare a donut, eh?
Yep.
Thanks.
They aren't there, Mr. Grizzly.
Okay, they weren't on the train when it got to Albany. They're not here. They gotta be somewhere.
Brilliant! Anyone could work that out. But where?
Where? That's a good question. Where? Blubber. Give me the state map of New York.
What are you doing? I'm talking to you. What are you doing?
Just shut up, Wesley.
Don't tell me to shut up. You're working for my father. You do as I say.
Look, kid, just shut up, okay? Somebody's gonna do some damage to you, and you're looking at the man that just might do it. Just sit there and behave, okay? Blubber, get us to the interstate. Going to the Adirondacks. Moose Lake. That's where they are.
Mom, how long am I going to stay here for?
Oh, I don't know, Amy. We haven't really thought about that much.
Can Hank and I go play for a while?
Dave, what do you think?
Yeah, okay, honey, but don't go too far, okay?
Amy! It's cold.
think it's this way, Mr. Grizzly.
Oh, shut up.
Oh, take that. Don't you think the
time is right? Look, like a couple of little puppy dogs.
I told you it wasn't down.
Shut up.
Oh,
could be to get you.
She's growing terribly fond of him, you know. We're gonna have to make a decision soon.
I know.
What?
Just shut up!
You're gonna get it!
Amy, you're not supposed to get hit that many times.
Come on, Blubber, we haven't got all day!
Well, it's not that cabin, Mr. Grizzly.
Right. Okay. Another cabin a little further into the woods. Let's go.
Are we gonna check every cabin on the lake, Mr. Grizzly?
Every one till we find them. Now, Blubber. Now!
No, we don't eat those. Are you hungry?
Amy?
Yeah?
You having a good time?
Yeah.
Okay, well, if you and Hank better come in now.
But why?
Because. It's time for dinner. Mom's got dinner ready.
Oh. Okay. I'm gonna...
That's the one. We've eliminated all the rest.
And there's a light on, Mr. Grizzly. They must be inside.
So what are we waiting for? I say we get them.
Yeah, we're gonna get them when they're asleep.
I say we do it now! What are you, chicken or something?
First rule of hunting, Wesley, is you take the prey when it's most vulnerable. We're gonna go in when they're asleep. We're unarmed, and surprise is our weapon. Do you have a problem with that, Wesley?
There's a shotgun in the trunk.
A shotgun?
My father never goes anywhere without a shotgun. Hundreds of people hate him.
Must run in the family, Wesley.
That's quite an arsenal, Wesley.
The little girl's mine, remember? I'm gonna pay her back.
Here, you take these. Blubber, take this. Take it. Wesley, you stay with me. We're still not going in till dark, you understand? Stop playing with that flashlight. You're gonna drive me crazy. Let's go, Blubber.
Oh, okay, whose turn is it now?
Seven. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven.
Ha ha, nothing for you again.
Okay. Eight.
Oh, I don't believe it.
You owe me $25,000 again.
Well, all I have is a pine cone left. I mean, I don't have any money. You've got it all.
Here, you can borrow some money.
It's great when a daughter has to loan her father money.
I don't mind.
No, you don't. But you know what? It's time to pack up the game and get ready for bed. It's late, okay? So go up and brush your teeth and we'll be up with Hank in a minute.
Mom, what's going to happen to Hank? I mean, all these people are looking for us. What if they find us?
Don't worry, Amy. No one's going to find us. No one even knows about the cabin, okay?
Okay. Good night, Hank. Oh! Good night, Mom.
Good night. See you in a minute.
Good night, Dad.
Good night, sweetheart. Hey, and not worrying's for you, too. Oh, sorry, Hank, I can't hold my wife's hand.
Check it out.
The girl is not... Get out of my face. Grizzly, I'm talking to you. I want you out of my house now. Now look, Grizzly, I'm going to calm down because I know we're all adults here, okay?
Hi.
Well, most of us are. But I know that you understand what I'm saying.
Blubber,
you can't go around
check upstairs.
My family alone. I'm going to be forced to call the police. And if I call the police, you're going to jail. Because I'll do it, and they'll put you in prison.
You went out the window, Mr. Grizzly.
Just shut up.
Hey, I found the lights.
If you get time off, I don't know, but I just want you to leave me. Ah!
You out there, little girl? I want you to listen to me. I've got your mother and father. But I also got a deal for you. All you gotta do is bring me the Yeti, and they're released unharmed. You understand? Bring me the Yeti. That's all I want.
Inca, what are you gonna do? I'm never turning you in. Ever.
Why don't we work these two over a bit? Make them yell.
Wesley? If you don't get back over here, I'm gonna untie them and I'm gonna let them work you over.
Never free them now, Hank. Not unless we get Big Jake Grizzly and the other two out. Wait a minute. Wait here, Hank.
It's been 5 minutes. I don't see her turning herself in yet.
Just give her a little more time, Wesley. Just a little more time. She's starting to get cold back now. Fear's starting to sit in. Just a little more time, Wesley. She's gonna be hammering at that door. She's gonna be begging to get in.
Well, Hank, that's great. You do that while I get the rope.
She's out there. I'll get him myself.
Clover, he's outside. Go get him. He's gonna roll him.
Stupid! Come on.
She's good. Real good. Not good enough.
I know you're here, little girl. You can't smoke me out, you know? The only thing you're doing is suffocating your parents, and that's not good. I got a deal for you, though. You bring me the Yeti, and I release your parents. Simple, huh?
Gotta be kidding.
Yeah.
The Yeti.
That was great. Very good.
Get Hank.
Amy! Amy, are you up there?
I was gonna look after that, you know.
Sure, honey.
Wesley! Wait up for me! Wesley!
Amy!
Amy!
I'm fine.
Okay, we're safe. It's okay to come on down.
Amy, be careful. Don't do anything until Dad tells you what to do.
Listen, get Hank in the car. Grizzly may wake up anyway.
Don't worry, Amy.
Okay, Amy, I want you to take it nice and slow, okay? I'm right here. Dad's here.
Okay, honey, you're almost there. A little bit further. Just take it slow. You're almost there. That's it. Just take it slow. Take it slow. Come right to me. That's it. That's it. You're almost there. Okay. A little further.
Hurry, Dave! Hurry!
Lover.
I know, Mr. Grizzly. It's all my fault.
You know, Blubber, that's the first thing I've ever heard you say that was right.
Okay, there's a key under the back mat behind the house, okay? I want you to go in there, go into my desk in the den, get our passports.
Did you get him?
Yeah, he's gonna meet us at Interstate 90. Bring our passports.
What do you mean?
Honey. I'm afraid we're gonna have to take Hank back.
No!
We have to. It doesn't belong to us, and it's not right for us to keep him here.
Why?
Well, Amy, if we were to keep him here, there would always be someone like Big Jake Grizzly trying to catch him, put him in a cage. You don't want that, do you?
Amy, we know it's hard for you. You've grown fond of him. But he's a Yeti.
He doesn't belong here. He belongs in the wild. And who knows? Maybe he's got brothers and sisters. And a mummy and a daddy who miss him very much. For his sake, Amy, we have to take him home.
I know it's right, Fred. I know it's the best.
Pull on that station up there, Glover.
You didn't happen to see a car come by here about 10 or 15 minutes ago, did you, with a man, woman, and child in it?
Sure, they stopped in for gas and made a phone call, too.
You didn't hear who they were calling, did you?
No.
Well, you see, it's real important. They're friends of ours, and we missed them down by the lake. They didn't tell you where they were going, did they?
Mentioned something about passports.
Passports. Wesley, where's the nearest international airport?
New York? Why?
You should have thought of it before. They're taking that Yeti back. Open the door. You get the car! Sit in the car! Come on!
Thanks. It's okay. Go ahead. Thanks, buddy. Things to me, Wesley. Let's have some fun, boy.
Kid, I've got a job to do, and I'm gonna do it without you. I can tell you that. I got something. My job's gonna get done without another minute of you.
Can I see you, Harry Jerk?
Oh, yeah, Harry, huh? I'll show you, Harry. Let's go, kid. Let's hit that.
Well, stay cool, kid.
Three tickets to Kathmandu via London. You'll have to hurry. It's final call, boarding gate number 6.
Thanks.
Enjoy your trip.
Thank you. I just thought of something. How are we gonna get the Yeti through security?
Can't Amy pretend he's a cuddly toy or something? Hank will keep quiet.
It's the only chance we have.
Hank, you can't move. You have to keep still. Hank, shh.
They're in here somewhere, Blubber.
Deli, that's the one.
Deli? Food.
It's them.
Excuse me, did you put your toy to the machine?
What are you doing? What are you doing with the gun?
Put that gun down! Who gave you that gun? That stupid kid Wesley gave you that gun, didn't he? Yes, this is your fault! We had that Yeti! You know we had that Yeti! We had that Yeti! This is your fault! Everything is your fault! It's been your fault from the very beginning! You haven't got their brains! God gave a garden slug! You're two sandwiches short of a full picnic! Your lights are... What do you want? What do you think, my rabbit's foot's loaded? Ooh, I'm scared now, boy! I got no gun!
I don't know where I pitched the tent. It's gotta be around here somewhere.
He's excited. I can tell. But I don't want to let him go.
Oh, you know you have to, Amy. This is his home. He won't be happy anywhere else.
Want me to take it? Pinecone. Thanks. What I always wanted.
I miss you, Hank.
Goodbye, Hank. I'll never forget you. Goodbye.
Yetis don't wave goodbye. They're not human.
Mommy, Dad, look!
What is it, honey?
Nothing. Let's go home.
My dear.
And one for me.
Thank you, Hayes. That'll be all.
Arnold.
Yes, darling?
What do you think ever became of Wesley?
Yeah.
trust that he